We're less than 24 hours away from the release of the Contract DLC in GTA Online. And over the past few days, we've got a bunch of confirmed info from Rockstar themselves, as well as a lot of leaks from high-quality leakers. That's pretty much confirmed to be true. So instead of making 50 videos going over every little bit of info as it leaks and comes out, I decided to wait, and I'm gonna let you guys know about absolutely everything we know about the DLC coming out tomorrow so that you're prepared. If you enjoy these types of videos, a thumbs up will be awesome. Subscribe for more stuff like this, and let's jump in. First of all, let's recap really quick what we got earlier in the week. So this is when this DLC was actually announced. Both in the newswire and in the trailer, we found out that Franklin is coming back, Dr. Dre is coming back, as well as DJ Pooh and a few others, including Chop. And my boy's looking a little old. This is the first new vehicle we sort of got a look at. Of course, we got Dr. Dre. We've got some sort of Porsche SUV that's going to be new. Below that, we found out that the whole concept of the story is going to be trying to get Dr. Dre's music back that he lost on the way to Kaya Perico last year. Then we found out about three new things coming to the game: the Compact EMP launcher, which looks like it could be really good, as well as the Enna's Jubilee, and the Agency, which looks like it's going to be the new business. We also got a look at the stun gun that's coming into GTA Online for the first time officially, as well as the Dubachi Champion, which looks kind of armored there, which could be cool, and the Armory. So what do we know about the Agency and the Armory since this? Well, according to Tez Funds 2 and a bunch of other leakers, I'll put the tweet on screen now. Supposedly, the Armory is going to be a type of upgrade for the Agency. We're not really sure what this upgrade is going to do, but we'll find out tomorrow. On Twitter, Tez Funds 2 relayed some info from Allocator, saying that the new garage space in the Agency is apparently going to be 20 slots, so a 20-car garage. That's good news. Apparently, we're also going to be able to add a vehicle workshop to the Agency, and that's separate from the Armory. The next new bit of info we got actually comes from the voice actor of Franklin himself. He leaked this image early on social media and deleted it quickly, but of course, everyone already screenshotted it. Too late, dude. I kind of think he might have meant to do it. That was a little bit of, you know, a tease. But this looks like the official artwork for the GTA Online contract, and we can get a lot of info out of this picture. Let's start off at the front and the bottom there. So on the left, we've got the Dubachi Champion. That sort of gives us a better look of what it's going to look like. We've also got the Enna's Jubilee, which we saw in the newswire as well. And then on the right, we've got the new supercar, or at least one of them. We did get a couple looks at this in the reveal trailer earlier in the week, but it's good to get another good look at it now. This thing looks expensive. Let's hope it doesn't break the bank. We've also got a bunch of characters that are going to feature in this DLC. Starting on the left, we got Chop, of course. My boy's getting old again. You can see some gray hairs on there. Hope you're doing well, Chop. Next to him is Imani, who's going to be the hacker in this DLC for us. We've got Franklin, of course, looking good. Then we've got a really tough-looking guy. He's got his thick gold chain. He could be the villain of the update. I'm not too sure. But he looks tough. We don't know who he is just yet. Next up, we got Dr. Dre, of course. To the right of him is DJ Pooh, Jimmy IV. Then we've got a mystery female character who we don't really know just yet. And then, of course, we've got Lamar. Another really interesting thing that people are kind of speculating about now is we can see the Mile High Club on the top left there. And I can't see any cranes. It could just be the angle we're at. And I don't know if it's just me, but it does look like it's a little bit further along in the construction process. Again, that could be complete speculation, or maybe they just didn't edit it the right way. Who knows? That one could be a bit of a reach, but I thought I'd mention it. And then in the top right, we've got what looks to be another new vehicle, an aircraft. There's been a lot of speculation online that this could be a drone. I don't really see that happening. I don't think that would be a good move. I think it's kind of too far away to really tell what this aircraft is, but it's new. We also get a look at two weapons in here as well. Franklin is holding the new heavy rifle. Now, these game files were in the game ever since launch, but it never actually came out. This is finally coming to GTA Online. It's the heavy rifle. Hopefully it's good. We can also see the guy at the back of the artwork holding a pistol. This actually looks really cool. I don't think this is in the game. I think this is a new pistol, but we'll have to wait and see. The next bit of kind of info we have is from Allocator, again, a reputable leaker on the GTA forums. And it looks like he was having a good time sort of trolling on the GTA forums here. He says, "I had this weird dream where I was chasing some targets and suddenly Franklin appeared in his buffalo, but it wasn't an ordinary buffalo, it was weaponized. When we finally caught up to the targets and killed them, I wanted to see if I could somehow gain access to this weaponized buffalo, but the only weaponized vehicles I could find were the Champion, Deity, Jubilee, and Patriot. The Deity, by the way, is the rumored name for that aircraft we spoke about earlier. Just when I thought I finally found out how to acquire the carb, I woke up and realized it was all just a dream. Or was it? Man, sometimes I can't tell what happened in-game and what was a dream. So yeah, as you can see, he's trolling. He's having a good old time. But if we're gonna believe this and take the hint here, basically, looks like Franklin could have a weaponized buffalo that we can't get. Potentially, we'll have to see, but interesting. And the final stuff we know about has to do with music. Of course, Dr. Dre is the main part of this DLC. Unless you want to say it's Franklin, they'll both play a big part. And obviously music is gonna be a huge part of this. So Dr. Dre has organized to sort of release a bunch of new music through the game, including a collab with Eminem, which is pretty big. On the music front, we've actually got a bit more info from Rockstar as well regarding potentially a new property. Kind of hard to tell what this is about right now, but Rockstar says stay tuned to the newswire for the latest news on the new music studio, where you can get a rare look into Dr. Dre's creative process at the new Record A Studios, as you, Franklin, and crew help to track down brand new unreleased music. So I don't know if we're going to be able to own this or if this is just a place we're going to get to go visit, kind of like the music locker. But Record A Studios is gonna be a new place. We'll go through all of the new songs being added to the game in just a minute, but we're also gonna be getting an all-new radio station in the game. It's gonna be called Moto Mami, as well as what they're calling major overhauls to both Radio Los Santos and West Coast Classics. So this DLC is gonna have a huge hip-hop rap sort of vibe, as you'd kind of expect. Shout out to Ash735 on the GTA forums. They've leaked all of the new songs coming in this update. So let's start off with Moto Mami, Los Santos. This is the entire radio station playlist by the looks of it. And while I'm excited to be getting a new radio station in the game, I'm actually really surprised at how big these overhauls are to the other two radio stations. So starting off with Radio Los Santos, these are all of the new songs being added. And you can see there's some pretty big names in there, man. There's been a lot of talk about Rockstar removing the licensing from certain games in the trilogy, removing a lot of people's favorite songs, and people were kind of thinking that they weren't willing to spend the money to get the songs in the game, but it looks like they've got the licensing for some really, really big songs here. There's some really big names here like 2 Chainz, Future, Migos, Polo G, Roddy Ricch, Tyler the Creator, Freddie Gibbs. It's, some really big names. And then looking at the overhaul, we're getting to West Coast Classics. Again, these are some huge names, man. We've got Tupac, 50 Cent, Dr. Dre, of course, that's kind of expected, including songs from him featuring Snoop Dogg. And then we've also got songs from other big names like Jay-Z. So that pretty much wraps up all of the info we've got on the DLC. That is, unless Rockstar releases a random trailer today, which, I mean, they could do. I'm gonna say they're probably not gonna release a trailer until it actually launches. Unfortunately, we didn't get any info on prices of certain things, so I can't really tell you how much money you should have saved up. But a general rule I'd like to go off is if you wanna buy all of the vehicles and properties in the DLC and sort of upgrade them a little bit at least, you're probably gonna want around $25 to $30 million. That's what history has told us. It could be more, it could be less this time, but if you've got $30 million, you're set. So we'll wrap it up there. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, and if you're looking forward to this update tomorrow, a thumbs up again would be appreciated. Subscribe for more stuff like this, and I'll see you tomorrow. Peace. Favorite color, money green. Paper. I've been on my grind since I was in the 7th grade.